Hello, my friends. In today's video, I want to show you how to build a UI collection view using a model view presenter pattern. I will compare it to the standard approach that uses model view controller, and I will show pros and cons of these two approaches. I'm going to use a simple app that has some color cells presented in a UI collection view. When I touch a cell, another screen opens. It has a background with the same color as the color of the cell. It also has a text describing the components of the selected color. Here is a standard way of building UI collection view that one can find in tutorials for beginners. In this approach, all elements are created inside a single view controller. The same view controller works as the data source in the delegate. The biggest drawback of this approach is the tendency of UI view controller to become too big and to perform too many unrelated tasks. Now, let's jump to the new project. I will start with a simple starting template that uses no storyboards. I built it in one of the previous videos. In this video, I will speed up the boring parts and will try to explain the most exciting stuff. The main idea behind this approach is to make the view controller have as little knowledge about the other classes as possible. To follow this plan, we need to pass the presenter from outside. This simple concept is called dependency injection. We'll inject the presenter with a new initializer called initWithPresenter. We'll need a new presenter class, let's call it colorCollectionPresenter. In the real project we would use a protocol, but to simplify the tutorial I would use the class implementation itself. Now, when we have the name, let's create the class itself. To demonstrate how the presenter works, I want to use it to specify the background color of the current controller. The only thing that I'm changing is adding the presenter property and assigning it inside the initializer. Now I need to use the presenter value to specify the background color of the current view controller. Using the presenter allows us to add any presentation related logic in a separate class instead of cluttering the view controller. To make our setup work, I need to change the initialization of the view controller in the app delegate. I am adding the new presenter and passing it to the view controller's initializer. Now, when the app compiles and shows the white screen, let's add the collection view itself. The view controller in our case is the V of view in M.V.P. That's why the code that creates the UI collection view goes here. The layout object specifies the visual properties of the collection view. For example, it tells the collection view how to place the cells, what spacing should be between elements, and what size each item should have. I use a standard flow layout and I add the small insets around the section. To have two cells in a row, I adjust the item size to the screen width and the insets. And finally, we are getting closer to the interesting part. The hardest decision is where to put the delegate and data source objects. I follow the idea that the delegate goes to the view controller, as it specifies or controls the behavior of the collection view. And the data source goes to the presenter, because it specifies the content that will be displayed. The presenter doesn't implement the UI collection view data source protocol. I need to add an extension that will implement it. To make it work, the object should also inherit from NS object. I don't have a model yet, so I am adding a simple parameter that will contain the data from the future model. Now it's just an empty array. Let's create a model. The color storage array is provided array of colors. In the real app, it could be a local database or a network storage. I will use a UI color extension that will add some nice colors described in the Apple's UI guidelines. The model grows and it's time to move it to a separate file. The colors property will be accessible from the presenter. It will contain the shuffled array of colors from the color storage. The function called updateColors will make shuffling and update the property. I am adding a completion callback to simulate a network or database call. The shuffle method is kindly provided by the gameplay kit framework. I need to cast it to the right type because the method returns an array of any. I am going to call this method on the main thread, while the real network call you probably should perform on a background one. Let's return to the presenter. Now we can add the real model and replace the empty array with the data from this model. Now we have everything we need to create our cells. In the example, the DataSource method is adding only one type of cell, but in the real project it could have some logic to include different cells based on the model data. That's where the view controller is usually starting to be dependent on the model, and that's why we moved this part from it. To use our app, we need to request the data from the model. To give the view controller the ability to do so, I am adding a new method to the presenter. It will call the update method in the model and pass the completion up by the chain. Let's request the data when the view is loaded and reload the collection view on completion. I am starting the app and it's crashing. The log tells me that I forgot to register a cell with the collection view. I'm quickly fixing it to see how it works. We can see the cells, but can't reload them yet. Before implementing a refresh function, I want to move the cell registration to the presenter. I believe it belongs there because the choice of the cell is another visual part that view controller shouldn't know about. It matches the ability of the presenter as a data source to create specific cells. Now let's add the standard refresh control. If the presenter will call the completion from the background thread, we'll need to call the reload data method from the main thread. Because this block of code is inside the let block, I can't use cell here. To fix this, I need to use the name of the class for the selector. And I forgot to add the Objective-C before the function. Let's assign our new refresh control to the collection view. I'm starting the view and refresh works. Each time I pull the collection view, the spinner appears and new randomized colors appear on the screen. I've finished with the UI collection view itself, and in the next 4 minutes I will be adding a color detail screen. I'm going to use the M.V.P here as well to demonstrate the usage of the presenter in the collection view delegate. The initial setup process for the screen is the same, so I'm not describing it in details and going straight to the implementation of the delegate method. In the DidSelectItem method of the delegate, we need the color of the selected cell to inject it to the view controller we want to present. We will get it from the presenter because only it has access to the model. To prevent crashes, I am adding the guard statement to make sure the index of the cell is not out of the bounds of the model's color array. Now we can call the method from the collection view delegate. I'm creating the details controller and presenting it. You can see that the data is passed correctly and the app is completed. There are a few things that can be improved in the app. First, I would add protocols to make neat interfaces for classes, and I would use the protocol in the constructor. Second, I would move the knowledge about the details view controller from the presenting view controller to a navigation coordinator or at least a parent object of the controller. The same approach can be used for UI table views. If you find this video helpful, please like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.